what are some indicators? Because mental health, it's broad. You know, there are people who we look at, we all know. And, you know, when we think of depression, we don't think of them. But these people are unmotivated. Some might even say lazy. They just have no oomph. They don't have that thing that makes them want to get up and do. Mm-hmm. Is there a way to distinguish for anybody? Am I depressed? Am I on the borderline of being depressed? Or am I just lazy? Am I just unmotivated as a human being?
That can be tricky, man. You know, the doctors always tell you, don't go to WebMD and start diagnosing yourself.
say that one more time.
The doctors will always tell you, don't go to WebMD and start diagnosing yourself because you have a stomach ache and you're walking there thinking you got testicular cancer.
Correct.
All right. So it's one of those things where it is very hard to self-diagnose issues like depression sometimes. And depression is a very nuanced thing within itself because it could be chemically induced. It could be environmentally induced. There are a number of contributing reasons as to why someone could have depression. I don't know how an individual distinguishes between what that's what we call self-deprecating thoughts. So, oh, I'm lazy. I'm not good for anything. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not motivated. I don't have it. And what I'll say to that is nothing happens for no reason. Nothing just exists because it exists. You feel a way because there's a contributing reason. Think about your feelings as a bar. There's a little hook on that bar that's weighing it down. And there's a hook on that hook. And there's a hook on that hook. And there's a hook on that hook. And those hooks represent things in your life that have happened that you either didn't completely cope, you didn't completely bounce back from, or you haven't found a way to acknowledge and cope with in a healthy way. So nothing just happens. Nothing's just there just because there's something behind it. I don't know if you can distinguish it if it's just you yourself. I think you really have to rely on your intuition to say, hey, something's not right, and to really work up the gusto to do something about it. Because perhaps you are just having a day where you do feel kind of lazy. You don't feel like doing anything. Or perhaps you're clinically depressed.
Yeah.
And I think that's more of a reason to really seek mental health professionals for preventative reasons, because you won't have to guess. You won't have to guess.
Now, well said, well said. You know, I'm going to switch the tone of this interview in a second, but I want to ask you one last question before I do that.
Good question, Sean. I see you, man.
Nah, I try to ask questions that I really want to know the answer to. Like, just again, I spoke about the pandemic earlier. I spoke about being quarantined. I'm typically a very, very upbeat, happy guy. I love nature. It is springtime in New York City.
This is still trees blowing in the background.
Yeah, man. Like, I'm feeling good. Like, but for months, living in one of the coldest freaking cities in the United States, like we in the house 8 months out of the year, on top of quarantine, what are some healthy habits that you can prescribe, that you can suggest, that we can all do to keep ourselves mentally strong?
For sure, man. Actually, I just started, May is Mental Health Awareness Month, and I started a 30-day mental health challenge, the Care Games Mental Health Challenge. And the point of the challenge is to have people dedicate some time in their day, every day, to their mental health. Like yesterday, the goal was just to do a stretch for 10 minutes.
Nice.
And I think sometimes, I'm not going to say what people do. I'm going to talk about myself, because I know I represent a lot of people with this. What I have a tendency to do is look at baby steps like they're not enough. Like, nah, change got to be this big grand boom, like this big explosive transformative event. And I look and I'm just completely dripping with difference. Like, it don't really work that way. Sometimes it's the little teeny steps you take every single day that lead to a massive change eventually. But I got to keep reminding my brain of that, bruh. Because I don't always feel that way when I'm struggling with stuff, but I can't You know what I'm saying? I can't make it happen. So doing something like a 10-minute stretch where I increase the range of motion in my arms, man, and my flexibility in my circulation, doing something like a brain dump. I actually got it right here where I just wrote down a whole bunch of thoughts. I gave myself 10 minutes and just dumped a whole bunch of thoughts down. I picked up a new hobby. Look at this. They ain't doing too well, but I got plants, man. I had to pick up new hobbies, man. I started using candles. I use candles in different fragrances now. I'm tired of seeing my own four walls. You have to do things that please the very small parts of you. You have to do things that please the very small parts of you. I went outside and I took a walk with no music, no nothing, and just sat and listened to the birds chirp. You know, I had my mask on and everything, but I still did that. I think it's changing the routine. I think it's establishing routine. I think it's taking to protect your mental health in this pandemic. I think it's looking at your habits that you do every day, figuring out what's healthy, what's not. I found out I'm eating so much food, bro. I'm not even hungry. I'm eating because I'm bored. You know, I'm trying to find a new hobby. I used to rap, and now I started writing down. I'll put an instrumental on. I'll write 8 bars real quick. It's interrupting the Groundhog Day nonsense that is the world we live in. But most importantly, Sean, it's remembering, bro, that this ain't normal.
There you go.
This situation ain't nothing normal about it. This is crazy. Because we renormalized it don't mean it's normal. You feel me? So I think those things are a really good start, man. Talking to people that you have fond memories with, talking to friends, making time for people, even if it's FaceTime, understanding your boundaries with the COVID. Some people, we double vaccinated, you know what I'm saying? Some people can come over the crib, some people cannot, you know? And it's uncomfortable to tell people they can't come through to the crib. So it's just a number of different things you can employ to kind of keep on top of your mental health. But remember, man, you're fighting in a war right now because the outside world is nuts.
Nah, well said and absolutely. What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.